And what's going on, y'all? This is your boy Scattered by Nature TV, Jeremy Speaks TV, giving you the real tea. We got Carl and Jamar 84 up here for the Chase Dallas panel. Tramell ass ain't here because the bitches are having drinks right now. But he kind of told us he wouldn't be here. He told me and Jeremy last night on IG Live that he wouldn't be able to make it, but he out here having drinks. He gonna text back saying, "Oh, I'm sorry, I'm trash. I'm out here. This is what I'm doing right now." That's what he said.
Well, at least she's aware she's trash. That's all we have. It's for accountability. Today, which is by coincidence, the name of today's topic today. But go ahead.
First of all, y'all ready to talk shit today? I know y'all are.
Yep.
Get on with the first topic. We ready.
Okay, so first things first, we pick up where we left off last week with Sean going off on Sean going off on DeAndre. Dior trying to calm Sean down. DeAndre tries to kick Sean out. Then DeAndre say that Sean was sleeping with Tilly Man. Then DeAndre goes off on everybody. Then Sean said, "I was going to leave, but then I realized that Dior had my keys, so I came the fuck back." Then he came back. George came and shaded the hell out of Tilly without saying a word. And then DeAndre left him with an almost $400 bill. Who wants to start this conversation off?
Well, first of all, when Sean said late last week, early into this week, this little last section, that section, and Kiki reiterated later on when she talked about how she thought she had somewhere to sit down, it was literally like a couch and a half, like that little corner.
Mm-hmm.
And we were like, I was like all in this girl's face. I think one of my dreads went into her drink while we were trying to film. Like, that's how close the next section was to us.
Oh, God.
Like, this DeAndre. What is this now? This is not a section.
It didn't look like one either.
Not a section, baby. But, baby, when he left them with that bill, when I tell you that we were all gagged.
Oh,
what happened to...
He probably gonna come back. He probably got a phone call.
But yeah, we definitely all gag because it's like, how you gonna invite everybody here, then go kick people out the section, and then instead of covering the actual bottle, you only give $100, and still there's $300 left to remain to split amongst. Now, granted, each person paid like 20 or whatever, but it's still just like this is all bad. It's all bad.
It's too
now
bad.
What I do?
No, not.
I don't know what happened. I just went black. I'm like, oh, okay.
Oh, I thought somebody called you.
Mm-mm, I don't know what happened.
Oh, yeah, but we was talking about DeAndre. Jamar brought up DeAndre leaving him with that high-ass bill after all that shit he was talking and kicking people out and all that other stuff.
Now, some ways I would like to be betrayed on TV, and that's just ain't one of them. It was the whole thing was unnecessary, and that all falls on DeAndre. You invited these people out. Child, you said you could pay for this, but you didn't. Like, what is happening? Like, it seemed like some scripted shit. Some shit I would have seen on a fucking scripted show. Oh, like, who does that?
Because she said, "Oh no, I'm." She said, "No, oh, no, I'm done with her. I'm gonna just give them $100 and I'm gonna dip."
Yeah, that's just no. That's just rude. I wasn't gonna. I wasn't surprised she ain't doing no confessionals. Don't do anything. Just leave. Don't even come out.
There was nothing he could say to explain that situation because you made yourself look like a complete fool.
I would have loved.
But I'm pretty sure watching him try to explain that situation is gonna be equally entertaining. I'm really curious to hear him explain why he did that. What was the point of it? Do you need scenes that bad?
Listen, okay, having him in this little ass section.
People in these sections. What happened to when we went to the club? We just partied. Child. Yeah, everybody want a section. Right.
But it was a security guard. I throw somebody out of that last section. That's why the straight folk ain't want y'all there. That right there. See, you made a spectacle. Yeah. You had to go and get a security guard and all of the rest of that. Like, it was too much for me.
Mm-hmm.
Girl. But it was funny, though.
I mean, it was.
But I was kind of nervous because like we was getting loud, and screaming, and I'm like,
"Yo, oh shit!"
Like this place is straight.
Like right, that's my thing.
Dude, like no, these are niggas.
Right.
So y'all doing all this?
Question: what possessed y'all to go there? Just ask.
That was DeAndre's idea, right?
Mm-hmm. Apparently, it was his thing.
It was his thing.
It was his thing, Cheryl.
He was supposed to show us the crew lounge in Houston since he was opening one in Dallas. Yeah. This was like the little.
So he came with the heteros, I guess.
That's why he can't dress.
And that's what that would be the messiest ones though.
They really do.
See, y'all know when you're with gays really on a regular basis, we read on like eating breakfast. It's just like what we do. We get catty with each other. But them gays that like to be with the straight, it's just like it's overload for them. Like too much reading and too much cattiness, they overload, they pop, and they act like that.
I mean, if you got something to say to me, Carl, just go on and say it.
I'm just saying, get with some gays, child. It'll calm your nerves a little.
Wait, you be hanging with the straights?
I do.
I don't know. You got a lot of gay friends.
Majority of my friends are straight.
It's like five gay people in Mississippi and the rest of them DM.
That's how many is in my friend group in Mississippi. It's like five of us in one group. I didn't get that many more gay friends until I started hanging with Jamar. Then when Jamar moved to Atlanta, he started hanging out with you and Tramiel, then they gave me more friends. And I'm like,
You know, Jamar's a gay. You know, we love Jamar.
Oh, that bitch is gay.
Jamar's a gay.
Then, you know, they gave me T and then Josiah, because Josiah got a big ass group of friends and stuff, which. Oof.
Yeah, expose yourself again.
Let's move on.
I ain't even say nothing, first of all. But anyway. But yeah, Jeremy, what are your thoughts on this bill? I know you have a lot to say.
I mean, like I feel like it's all Sean's fault. I feel like it's all
Sean in it.
Sean started this whole thing. You got amnesia because it's been a minute since we've seen the last episode. But like Sean started this whole argument between him and DeAndre. Now that don't take away the fact that Deion may or may not be a broke ass bitch, but
not allegedly.
I mean, like, but at the end of the day, I feel like Sean started that fight. He started it, and he knows that he was going to trigger. He knew that he was going to trigger DeAndre. Like, DeAndre just so happened to be, you know, broke, frumpy, a stunt queen, you know, a little fluffy, you know. It's just, I feel bad for DeAndre. Like, I would hate to appear in front of 40,000 people every week as a hating, you know, nasty attitude having, you know, bad body, bad dressing, you know,
Bernstein
Bear giving, you know, broke ass stunt queen ass bitch. I would hate that. And I feel for him because after that scene, I wouldn't show up no more either. I know the embarrassment.
So, in other words, you can have him coming on the scene looking like a ragamuffin. But, you know, throwing shade. I get it. Because he looked like a ragamuffin in this scene, too. Want to throw folk out this last section. Not I'm on your side, Sean. Fuck that bitch. Fuck that tacky bitch and that raggedy ass section. They can have it. I was on Sean's side. I've been put out of better places, bitch, and I know I have personally. I've been put out of way, but I got put out of Walmart before, girl. So this
is my god.
Me too.
I was on Sean's side.
I scared the TV as orange.
He's filled with so much, and like you can tell that he's filled with so much anger because you can tell that all throughout his life. And I understand like what it is to battle colorism, you know, and deal with, you know, rejection and things like that. Like you can tell that he's battling a lot of inner demons and a lot of rejection. And whenever he feels like he's dealing with a little bit of rejection, a judgment, he just lashes out at people. but that's not the way you had, that's not the way to respond or come to, like, you know, some type of resolution. It's only going to make the situation worse, especially when you're not giving like that because you're not that grit, you know?
Mm.
You know, so like, much love to him. You know, hopefully he has a little bit more than them $125 in the bank account.
And shout out to Keyshawn for being a Sigma. I ain't know you was a Sigma. I ain't know you was a pledger. Shout out to Sean. I fuck with Sigma.
He's not a pledger.
I ain't know you was a pledger.
And
it makes sense that you was a Sigma.
So it's which one is Keyshawn? Is that the trans woman or is that the other one?
No, Keyshawn is Sean.
So what's the other one's name?
What other one? Kiki?
Yeah, what's her name?
Kiki.
Oh, I thought her name was Keyshawn.
No, that's Sean's name.
I thought Sean was just Sean.
Nah.
I mean, they use both. So,
yeah.
So Kiki's real name is Keyshawn, too?
I don't know what her name is. I just know her name is Kiki.
As far as we know.
As far as we know, her name is Kiki. Yeah. I don't know her real name.
Nothing else. I don't think it's short for nothing.
Okay. Are we also talking about what Kiki said happened in the scene?
We are in just a second. Okay. What do y'all think about DeAndre saying that Sean slept with Telly's man?
I was trying to figure out who
probably did.
But which man? Yeah. Telly got a lot of them. Which man?
He was sitting on the new man lap just recently. He fine too. An older daddy. I said, okay, Telly, that's right on my alley.
I saw that on Instagram. I'm like,
I mean, with all the allegations and all of that that we are seeing in these scenes, I want to know, are these people knowing that this is being filmed? Because y'all can't be this naive and not knowing that y'all are being filmed, or y'all just doing a lie. It's a lot of storylines that's being written. At this point, I'm confused. Like, you can't be sitting on this man lap, that man lap. You know, you see the little red light on that camera. I'm like, are y'all not paying attention, or y'all just don't give a fuck? I'm just confused. I don't understand why we're having all these sit downs over stuff y'all are just obviously doing on camera. And then now you're mad about it. I don't get it.
Yeah, like, and like, are you talking about Tedley or Sean?
Well, both. Hell.
Like who got a lap strong enough to hold Sean up?
Sean don't look that DeAndre. Big for me.
Sean look like he's a whopping 6'8".
DeAndre can handle the child.
Yes.
Is he that big?
I don't think he that big, man.
No, Sean is a tree.
Oh.
Oh, I know that.
He look like it though. He do look like it.
It's a tall motherfucker.
Oh, shit. That's why when he mentioned that shit, I'm like, well, which man he talking about? It might be a man that telling him, said, okay, no, I'm not gonna deal with this one. I'm done.
He said he ain't had one, so I don't know which one it was that he was in.
Cause that came out of nowhere. It must have been a piece from a long time ago.
But what you mean, Tally does have a man? Do y'all forget the beginning of the whole season?
He gone.
Obviously, because that show won't the man lap that I saw him on IG with me. That's two different days.
Well, y'all know how
I know that for a fact.
Because when I saw him sitting on that man lap on that older guy lap on Instagram, I'm like,
okay.
Rule number one, never bring a man to a TV show because they'll never make an episode 3.
You know what I said? I looked, I said, like.
Okay, period.
I clicked the like button real fast when I saw that.
There now, he is.
George shading Tedley when he came in.
George is so crazy.
George is funny.
George is a mess.
It was good to see George back on there.
It was. But George is a kiki. I swear. He looked good, though. Ooh, that suit, George.
He seems the most prepared out of everybody on the show. Like, he knows what to do, what to say in the scenes to be entertaining. And he knows how to read at a very high level. Like, I don't really think
nobody else. I agree. Yeah.
Nobody else on the show really seems to know how to read. Like, you know, Sean can't read. I mean that in both senses. You know, I don't think Trey can really read. Dior don't really read. I feel like Dior could, but Dior don't really read nobody. You know, Kesey.
Oh no, Dior read DeAndre at the beginning at the color party. He said, "Yeah, don't dress me again." That's not what I said. Very direct.
But like, What do you feel is the root though? Versus like you checking somebody. I mean, you can anybody could check anybody. But to me, reading is verbally lacerating somebody, like, you know, in
so
body bag. I don't know what you're talking about. See, I don't really think I'd be doing that much.
I want to ask a side question. What is the very thin line between reading somebody that you like and reading somebody that's your friend?
Well, I don't read my
friend. You should know.
I don't
read my friend. What you're talking about,
but
you should know.
The rest of the guests?
You
ain't really a thin line.
You ain't.
I read everybody the same.
That's why I ain't saying nothing about you, Carl, because you read me and Jamar, so I ain't got shit to say about that. But T and Jamar should know, because they want to act like they don't be reading and shading my ass all the time. Oh, I forgot. Jeremy, too. Y'all should know.
Now, why am I in it?
Because you do it. You just did it on Tramiel Live yesterday. Just reading me.
No, I do not.
But ain't nobody worse than Jamar. That bitch can read me with just her eyes. And that's all that matters.
Me?
And there go the bullshit. That's the fake shit that's right there.
Crazy. That's wild.
You and T. And T shades me on all his lives. And be talking about, because you know I could be a hoe or a slut bucket like Scotty right now, but you know I ain't gonna do that. And I'm like, why the fuck am I in it?
But
I don't know what you're talking about.
However,
okay. We gonna be fake today. Okay.
However, mere moments ago, you were just up here fanning yourself. I'm just like,
where was I fanning myself?
In between your legs.
You see what I'm talking about?
Not happen.
Say shit. Tedley and the old man, and you were sitting there fanning your coach, man.
I was not fanning myself. Y'all need to stop gaslighting. That's what y'all need to stop doing.
Why can see you? It is a glass door, bitch.
You are full of shit. All you do is sit up here and play games and make these people think that you so nice when you are the shadiest one up here.
Listen, it's all recorded. The recording is right here. They can see it. They hear it. They know it.
You know what?
Go ahead, bitch.
Fuck you, okay? I can't fucking stand you. I can't win with you. I can't. Anyway, so do y'all want to just go into what Kiki said happened at the scene, or do y'all want to?
Well, I'll follow your lead. So
okay,
I'll follow whatever you want to do.
Okay, well, we already talked about this damn near $400 check, so we ain't got to talk about that. So the next morning, Trey and Tedley, they were sitting up talking about what was going on with Lon D. They were talking about what happened with DeAndre the previous night. Kesey, Jeff, and Sean came in, and Chef talked about the Tedley situation, meaning he don't understand why, you know, DeAndre brought that up when he and Tedley already had that conversation, and he feel like DeAndre has animosity with only him and Tedley, and then they go around waking everybody up like they Tanisha from the Bad Girls Club.
Yeah, I call
that. Like, bitch, I ain't get no sleep because of y'all. I ain't get no sleep because of me.
Blah, blah! Blah, blah!
Good times, good times.
Good TV. I miss the Bad Girls Club. Oh my god.
Now y'all do that shit to me and maybe piss.
Listen, baddies will never be Bad Girls Club, okay? But do y'all think that DeAndre has more animosity for Tedley and Sean than anybody else on the show? And if y'all think so, why do y'all think he do?
I don't know. I feel like he came in with a guard up already. Like, I feel like it's a lot of things that could have possibly happened behind the scenes that we didn't see. Because hey, this is just my analysis right here. I'm just assuming it gotta be. For you to be coming with as much energy as you brought to the show, something's happened to where you feel like you had to come here and prove yourself or something of that nature. That's what it is given to me.
Markel is in the back.
I didn't even know he was back there. My bad.
Private chat.
Oh, I didn't even know. Hold on, wait a minute. So now we have Markel with the mess.
Why? Why I gotta be Barkel with the mess?
Because every time you go live on IG, it be the mess.
Oh well.
And I miss I miss the lives every time. So
I'm currently blocked right now, so I can't go live. I had a lightly friendly threat to somebody, and IG said no. But hey.
What's going on? We just recapping. Carl,
why you so what's going on, friend? Oh, you know, I'm just relaxed. I'm chilling.
So I'm gonna tell you. So, by the way, you're aware of everybody except Jeremy. So, Jeremy, this is Markel, and Markel, well, this is Jeremy. I've been watching. I know. Ooh. Now I'm glad you know this now. Well, I ain't gotta let you know shit. You said you've been watching, so you know what we give over here. So it don't even matter. So, where are we? Okay, Jeremy, was you about to say something in regards to whether or not DeAndre has more animosity towards Taylor and Sean than he does anybody else on the cast? Were you finna say something about that or no?
I don't even think we were talking about that. I thought I thought Carl was saying something.
He was talking about it, but he already got done with his point already.
And we were talking about what again?
Sean said that he feels that DeAndre has more animosity for him and Tetley than anybody else on the cast. And I was asking you, do you think that's true? And if you do think it's true, why?
I mean, I feel like DeAndre has a lot of animosity towards Sean because Sean keeps on like initiating issues with him. I feel like Sean keeps on picking at him, and like he's an easy read, so you know he's a little bit fed up. But I don't know if he has like a lot of animosity towards Tedley. I don't get that. I feel like he has animosity towards Trey and Sean. To me,
but why do you think that though?
I feel like because they like he probably wants to feel like he's like accepted by them or whatever the case may be, and they keep on rejecting him. Maybe that's why, because he just don't fit in. You know, he can't dress. You know, he can't pay for the bottles. You know, he can't death.
So drive. He's the ugly girl that can't fit with the plastic. Basically.
But the thing is, he's not ugly. Facially, like he's not an ugly guy. He just doesn't have the. You can tell he doesn't have
his personality makes him that way. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Well, not so
with Wednesday, he ain't wearing pink.
His insecurities manifest inside of his personality, and it makes him very unlikable. Like, have you ever saw somebody who was very insecure and they always mm-hmm. are like, you know, negative or self denigrating, and you just okay. you don't want to be around them?
I agree. Yeah. I agree with that. I agree.
I've seen it.
I don't know what Tedley is though. It's
still like if you insecure, hate yourself at home and be happy in public. Like, still gonna attempt to punk, you know, Trey and
Rob just want to slap the shit out of somebody. I don't think he care who it is at this point.
I don't think he want to slap the fuck out of nobody. I think he want to intimidate them to think that he will, because if he wanted to, he would have already done it. Because he ain't scared.
I feel like they always backpedal a little bit because they probably know he will slap the shit out of their ass. I don't see a lot of bitches is ready to get down on there like that.
I mean, if he's saying that he wants to fight and you want to fight, regardless if he sit down or stand up, you've already announced what you want to do, so go and do it.
I'm just here for Trey Howard in the person air. That's all I was waiting on.
I was screaming, Sean.
I'm so over the empty threats. It's so like, it's at this point, do something. You ain't scared to go to jail. You ain't scared to have a record, and you do nails for a living.
I think it's one of those things where Robert did state that he knows that he can beat Trey up. So he's like, well, what's the point?
I mean, then why are you threatening and trying to physically intimidate people that you know you can beat up?
Well, you know, that's something that we can ask at the reunion.
Y'all gonna have a live audience because we ask the questions like they're doing Jerry Springer.
Right. Get off my boo. Let's go on down the line, D.
I do want to do something different this year. I would like for everyone, for those people who have questions, I would like for you guys to send in a video question so we can play them for the actual cast member. So if you guys would like to participate,
now you have a important landscape for your question.
So it's not misread, it's not misunderstood. We got to say your tone of your question.
Look, now I'm about to fight him with the next event, bitch.
This seating.
Like, yeah, the question is for Robert Ray. I just don't like
that. That sounds like a trap. That sounds like a trap. You have like this pre-recorded video, and then they can read you down, and you can't say nothing back.
Okay. Where we put our video in?
Oh, bald-headed bitch, shut up.
Yeah. Send me the link. I'll send it in 5 videos. I'm a different shirt on every video.
So if you guys are interested, please send it to me on next Friday.
Oh, Lord. I got to think about
it. I'll send you my questions directly.
Me too. I got to think about it.
I got to think about it because I don't want no drama, child. I don't want nobody trying to hit me in my mouth with these.
I want all smoke. I'm going to get real cute in all my videos.
Is
like,
there
an
email that we send this to? Is there an Instagram?
You can send it to info@mychasingreality.com or you can just DM it to me. No, don't DM it. Send it by email so we can have good quality.
Okay, so do you feel I'm talking
is
to you,
this
Markel.
Interview? Is it for me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you feel that DeAndre at certain points in this on this show has been, you know, provoked?
Absolutely.
By who?
Cast members.
That members would have.
No, the thing, you can't come up here and don't want to answer the question. This is what it is.
Okay, so I think that he's been provoked by Sean for sure.
Okay, so you agreed with me when you came in here and you were asking me if I...
So that's why I asked. I wanted to clarify because I came in, you know, I was a little buffering over here. I wanted to clarify what I heard.
Okay.
But I do agree with that. But anybody else...
You don't think Trey also kind of provoked him, especially at the club when he had good energy?
At the club? Trey?
When he brought them out and said, you know, just so y'all know, it's about to be a diss song about y'all.
Maybe not provoking.
Not provoking.
And on top of that, wasn't they talking about his shoes too?
Oh, you said about that evening. I'm sorry. I thought
you said she can't dress.
Huh?
So you just—it's a reality show. That'd be a real thought that they had at the time.
But I'm saying, yeah, I just want us to. I'm just okay. I'm not on the show. I wanted to be clearly stated who I feel is antagonizing him because I don't think
that Trey is antagonizing Dre. I do think Sean, but I think mainly just Sean. Everybody else is just like a catalyst of things.
Why do you feel Sean is antagonizing him? Why do you feel Sean is antagonizing him?
I can't say. That's going to be talked about at the reunion.
media train.
Look, I'm just saying, like, I feel like they both part of the grizzly bear community. So at this point, I'm just saying, like, they should get along. They look to me, they have the most similar characteristics.
Oh my god!
Now you do not believe that yourself.
Suppose if this was like,
let me turn my camera off.
Divergent. anybody ever seen Divergent before? You know how you got different factions.
I've never seen it.
Let's strip off everybody's clothes, and what you see is just the actual person. If you see DeAndre and Sean walking to the room, they have very similar characteristics. Both of them are a little bit on the larger side, and that's both of them are dark skinned. Both of them are, you know, voluptuous.
Not BBW.
I don't get, because I don't like that. I don't get why people who has this like similar characteristic to the people that they're picking on decides to pick on those people.
Well, let's not call them grizzly bears. We don't want to be called colorists.
Is Sean picking on the same issues that he has himself to DeAndre? I'm asking.
Now you get what I'm saying. I mean, yes, because both of them can dress.
Damn, Jerry.
But fashion is subjective.
Very much so.
The thoughts and opinions of Jeremy Speaks TV has absolutely nothing to do with Scott About Nature TV.
I have to get this out. nothing is wrong, with him thinking that he can dress. You know, but I'm saying, like, why pick on this person when y'all have similar characteristics? Is it because you in with the cool girls and he not, and you want to distance yourself from him? Not saying that they are friends anyway, but I'm saying, like, out of all of the girls, like, with the looks on the show, DeAndre and Sean are going to be the farthest amongst from.
But it's not computing to me. Like, your analysis is not computing to me, because that's like saying, because Trey and Dior have like outlandish fashions, then that means that if they go against each other, why do it because they're similar?
That's the same thing. I guess what I'm saying, let me just put out an example. Have you ever seen like a token black girl inside of a white girl clique or heard of that? And there's another black girl that comes to the school. Now, this token black girl has went through a whole bunch of hazing, discrimination, all of these things that over the years. And when she sees this girl who can remind her of herself, you would imagine that she would take that person in and be like, okay, so this is how I go. But no, she's going to be with the white girls and she's going to pick on the black girl to further separate herself from that black girl to be in with the popular, with that popular clique.
So Chase and Dallas is mean girls, basically.
I'm saying like Sean and Trey, when they're together, give me mean girl energy.
You sound like Tammy Roman. I said the fucking popular people.
Because that's what it's given.
Do you not get it when I'm breaking it down like that?
I get what you're saying.
I get what you're saying, but I just don't agree with it.
Okay, that's fine.
I love
it. But I just want to put it out there. I don't think he can dress. I think they know that. I think we've all got it. And if we rank in their fashions, DeAndre and Sean are about at the same level. Actually, I might have to take away 1 point for Sean because of the shoulder pads.
I said the popular people.
I just don't like that. I feel like Sean keeps on antagonizing him.
But like, let me say this,
because he did it at the club too. You forgot?
No,
why do we always criticize everybody's fashion on these particular shows?
I mean, because he's calling himself a fashion girl and also critiquing other people's fashion.
He's a fashion blogger.
Okay, well, he was also talking about DeAndre's fashion.
What we learned on these shows is whatever you come in introducing yourself,
notice how you don't live up to it,
they're gonna do it. So if you mention fashion anywhere in your title, you already know the girls gonna eat you up.
I didn't bring up
Astro. Astro is not like a fashionista or anything. But Astro wasn't out here talking about people's outfits.
He was not.
And talking about people's shoes. Oh, you got Toms on. Or whatever the case may be.
When I think about Toms, I think about the medicine.
Meanwhile, you're dressed in the confessional like a Powerpuff Girl. Like, I don't...
Now, don't sleep on them Toms now.
Don't Toms come from Payless?
No.
Do you think that Sean could be provoking, in air quotes, provoking DeAndre, and... DeAndre may be getting what he has given other people, because he has provoked people for no reason as well.
I agree with that whole statement.
Do you think that that's kind of his karma for doing what he's done to other people? Because he came on the show antagonizing people.
Absolutely.
And then, like, I'm like, okay, I'll let you know why I'm irritated by Sean.
And it's
because I was like, during this, after the show, I watched Sean get on the Chasing Network channel And he's sitting here talking about all of the different privileges he does not have. You know, I don't have a pretty girl privilege. I don't have a light skin privilege. I don't have a masculinity privilege. I don't have a food stamp privilege. He's just saying all of this stuff that he has to fight against. But here you are in the scenes, antagonizing and like starting with a girl who literally probably battles the same stuff that you got that you go through. It don't make sense.
I mean, but we can't sit here and talk about like DeAndre wasn't annoying and shading people for no reason.
No, I'm not saying that. But why is was he really going at Sean though?
Was who really going at Sean?
DeAndre.
Did DeAndre coming at Sean is what I'm asking.
No, Sean kind of started it.
Sean started because the scene was basically Sean just saying what he heard from Ted Lee about the whole like faking the scene or something.
And that's what I'm saying. Now the other girls have a reason to have disdain towards Sean. I mean DeAndre, but they don't really have any feelings towards him. Yeah, he may be annoying, but like they're not studying him like that. But Sean goes out of his way to trigger him. Like this whole fight at the place, although Sean came off like a broke bitch. I mean, not Sean, but DeAndre came off like a broke bitch. Sean started that fight.
But honestly, I ain't gonna lie to you, and I could be a little bit biased when I say this, but I don't mind Sean being on DeAndre's ass because DeAndre was on everybody else's ass, so he could deal with it. That's how I feel.
You should be okay with Lon D being on that ass.
Maybe so, but I mean, I don't like DeAndre on this show, and I don't give a damn who on his ass. So it is what it is.
You don't like DeAndre. Okay, so can we do a raise of hand? Who does not care for DeAndre on here?
So I don't care for DeAndre on this show.
Oh, shit, hold on.
Yeah, on the show. I don't know him in person.
Yeah, I don't know him in person, but on the show.
Yeah, on the show, he's not my favorite person.
So even though he's not your favorite, do you feel like he's entertaining enough or bringing, like, mess?
Yes.
Hell yeah. Crazy delusional people make great TV.
So would you like to see him again?
He can come back.
Yeah, absolutely.
He can come back.
But the thing
they make
is,
good TV.
But the thing is,
you need a villain.
Is he gonna be able to stand by his decisions? Is my thing. Like if you're gonna like be on the show and you want to be the villain and you want to be the bad girl, then you need to stand 10 toes down in that. Go get a stylist and then be the bad girl that you really want to be. So because if you want to be the villain, you can't get red. You gotta have your fashions down to a T. You gotta be elegant. You can't give them anything to read. You gotta make them read. You can't be an easy read. Then on top of that, be
right.
a villain at the same time.
I agree with that.
Yeah, and then stand 10 toes down in the stuff that you did. Don't like stop showing up to the confessionals because you know that you embarrassed yourself and you look like a fool on camera, you know. But I don't know. Maybe I'm completely wrong about this, and I don't know. I'm not anywhere close into what you're already thinking, Markel.
That boy's so damn silly.
Hold on, I'm about to end this live over here. I'm sorry. That's why I keep looking over here. I'm on the last like 6 seconds.
Okay.
Oh wait, you're on live. They can hear what we're saying.
No, I was running the
running the chasing after show while he doing this.
That's why I kept like
looking. Yeah, okay. Oh, okay. So I guess we at the part where we were talking about Kiki and the situation that happened at the club, and she was explaining why she left in so many words, she's saying that the men ain't no gentlemen to her. That's basically what she's saying.
Basically, what happened that night is she said that she went to the bathroom, and when she went to the bathroom, all the guys was just saying, like, hey, you're there with those faggots, those punks, or whatever. Like, because in that moment, granted, we can go wherever we want, but in Houston, that crew, it was very...
It was
a lot going on, and we were just in that corner just acting a fool. Now, mind you, Trey comes in.
Dario back again.
His skin tight clothes. Like everybody's not looking. It was just a lot going on. So when the guy came and he was just saying, "Hey, you with those faggots and things like that," she felt uncomfortable. Because when she came over there, nobody moved and gave her a seat. Now I don't remember her asking for a seat because I was holding the camera, so I wasn't really focusing on that. But that was her experience. Now, what were y'all saying?
Hold on. Okay. I want to emphasize this. I want give them a description of how little that section was.
Okay, we got to find about the section, y'all. So how small?
Probably, it was like a little small truck. I mean, a small V. It was a corner, and it was like maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe like 6 people could really sit in there. But the way it was laid out, it was almost like a big long couch. So we thought we were in, we thought we had that whole area, but that wasn't the case. So it was squashed up in this little thing. So it was very tight.
Would I be rude if I say, okay, let me frame this in a correct way?
You're gonna be rude as fuck. Go ahead.
You know what? Never mind.
Just say it.
I'm letting go. I'll let it go. It's a touchy topic. It's touchy. So, but why are you on the show then? I mean, like, if you feel that you deserve to be treated differently, people have to be a gentleman towards you. You know, I don't understand that. And then on top of that, like, you don't want to be viewed as being with those quote unquote faggots. I'm saying, then what's the, you know, and you left them there. I mean, and she was talking about her personal safety. Like, what if something was to happen to her? But I'm saying, like, you know, you already know the dangers of being a trans woman. You know, and then to
I
do
agree. It's like, why she hot-tailed her ass out of there. Keep like Kiki, bitch, run.
And I'm
run,
saying, like,
bitch.
And you already know, like, that you're out here with these LGBT men, and you know that, like, this is a reality show. It has a proclivity to get a little bit, you know, heated. So why do you like? I didn't understand. So I'm saying, like, why do you feel? Why do I have to give up my seat for you?
You should have given her. She's a woman. I'd have gave her my seat for a
while. Well, because she's a woman, and so the even on the video you saw where like we were sitting, and Kiki was clearly sitting behind us, like she wasn't in our area. She just wanted to be in our area, so like if something was to happen, she's more safer than on the outside.
I get that. I don't see nothing wrong with it.
But I thought that her issue was that she felt that because she was sitting next to them, or being next to them while they were doing all of that because of the stray guy said, are you with them faggots? She felt uncomfortable to be in that. So I'm saying she didn't want, if that's the case,
well, she
didn't want
to
be comfortable
because she was by herself. So when she came back, she wanted to sit in our section, but there was no room and nobody heard her.
There was like nowhere to stand next to y'all either?
No.
Jamar said no.
Okay, so I don't understand it, but I guess I understand, but I just was confused when it came to this whole, you know, I guess I didn't, I was really trying to understand what it is, because I was like, is it the lack of chivalry? Is it that the straight men were making you feel uncomfortable?
I think
you didn't want to be
above.
Okay, well, I'm saying that at that point, if you don't want to be clocked, Cause she's not very clockable. Like she easily passes, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, but I'm saying if you don't want to be clocked, being with this group of people, it's not gonna work for you. Cause it's good. They're gonna be like, wait a minute. Like she said, she was like, if they just looked at me one more time,
yeah, like, she didn't feel safe. I don't see nothing wrong with that.
I'm
though.
Saying if that is the case, then why even be a part of this? Cause you're always gonna have.
I mean, I will be a part of something. If I'm going, like, y'all want to do a scene, let's say doing a reality show, y'all want to do some shit right in the bumblefucks of goddamn banking. Now, bitch, I will film y'all show, but if at any minute I feel like a shootout about to happen, fuck y'all this show, and I'm getting the fuck out
ASAP. The difference is, like,
it ain't that deep.
Like, she is a part of this show. However, we didn't know, or they didn't know, like, at that moment, it was going to be chaos, you know? We just thought, right, you know, on a cast trip, we're going to hang out. It may be some conversations that need to be held. But even when DeAndre was talking to Jeff and Keyshawn, in the beginning, it wasn't heated. And it just escalated. So, like, nobody was expecting that. So, you have to come into the situation, like, aware it could or could not. And if you don't feel comfortable, you have the option to leave.
So would a solution be like that? It only should, it, they, the cash should only be at, you know, LGBT friendly environments.
One more point against DeAndre. He knew that play. He made that little ass section, that little ass straight ass club. So no, ma'am.
Well, no,
you better find you a fan club and bring us there where I'm safe.
I'm not gonna say that because we're only limited to what, 7 places that we can go every single time we film. So we're not gonna do that. But I also don't live a trans experience, so I don't know.
Yeah.
But I know for her, she's probably like, listen, I've transitioned. I think I look passable. I don't know. There's all these straight thug men looking like they ready to fight at any given moment because they went pat nobody. Well, were they pat people down? They just said we couldn't bring our cameras. But like in that moment, if Trey would have probably looked at one of them and just rolled his eyes any type of way, they probably would have came over there and had a whole fight. It was a lot going on.
Not transphobia.
Because the area, you know, you can go into some, you know, straight spaces and it'd be like, you know, you feel cool, but that night in particular, the people, maybe we were just loud and annoying, but they just felt the energy wasn't right. So I was kind of like, girl, I don't know how you're going to get up out of here.
But we were also like, granted, there were music playing, but they were yelling over the music and standing up on the doggone thing and just, bitch, my bad. Like, it was just crazy, and everybody's looking at us like security looking at us, and we look in. It was a lot going on.
Damn, y'all sound lit. I want to come party with y'all.
Who brought these gays here?
I didn't write that. Like, hey,
okay, security.
I was happy that she left like that. Like that's what I felt like she should have did from the get go. Like,
but there's a. Oh, I can't say. Go ahead.
Oh, is that like, were you going to say there's a fine if you leave a scene?
No. There's not a fine if you leave a scene. There's a fine if you stand us up. There's a fine for that. There's a fine if you don't, if you have us wait for a scene too long, there's a fine.
Okay.
I heard that.
I don't like to film long. I like, if it's a scene between one or two to three people, 30 minutes max. If it's a group, depending on what the topic is, an hour max. And I like to go. And they'll tell you, well, Markel, you missed it. Well, girl, y'all should have argued when I first got there. I'm not here all night.
Y'all should have argued when I first got there.
They wanted me to come to so many balls. What time the ball start? 2 a.m.? I'm not coming. Sorry. Send me a video. I'm not doing
it. Okay. It was like pull their phone out.
I know that's my bitch.
Okay. What's next? Do we want to talk about the Trey and George thing where they catch up and George explains his beef with Ted Lee?
No, I don't.
When did that happen? Do I not remember that scene?
Yeah, it was real quick. It was right before the big beefy scene.
Yeah, it was right before it.
Because we can skip over because I feel like, well, at the reunion we'll get more clarity because that wasn't enough for me.
I'll say something before we step over. I have a real big issue when people who were your friends, when y'all fall out, they spray you with stuff that you like talk to them about.
I agree.
Although I feel that George is cute and you know he can read. I feel like he's one of the strongest. I feel like y'all probably it probably is a hit to the show, maybe of him leaving. Like, or going to Atlanta because, like, to me, I feel like he definitely has, like, you know, centerpiece energy. Like, he can, like, the girls would be centered around him. Maybe because he's just been doing this for so long. I don't know. I'm new to all of these.
Well, he was definitely a cast member, and he was casted to be on this season, but he ended up getting offered in Atlanta, so he just...
Yeah, so, like, but like I was saying, I just don't like... those type of friends. Like it proves how you're not really that great of a friend anyway. The moment that we fall out, the moment that we get into it, you're gonna spray me with all of the stuff I've ever vented to you about, talked to you about, and I just think that's real low and nasty.
So you think that Ted Lee sprayed George or George sprayed Ted Lee?
I think George sprayed Ted Lee. I don't remember Ted Lee saying anything about George's personal business.
So what personal business did George spread?
Well, all of the times that he was crying to me on the phone, crying to me about these people, crying
well,
to me about
personal, though.
Yes, it is. Like, regardless, you don't like, you don't throw back in my face anything that you did for me as a friend after we end things. And then the whole reason that y'all ended, it wasn't even like Ted Lee betrayed you, Ted Lee did something wrong. What he said on this episode was that him and Ted Lee fell out because he just didn't want to be around that group no more. So I'm saying if that is the case, then what is all of the vitriol and anger about? Is it because you're hurt that he decided to make that decision?
It's because that's not the case. And George and Telly really don't want to talk about the situation on camera, but they will talk about it at the reunion.
Are they gonna talk about it 100%? Like, where's it gonna be?
Are we just gonna be
tapping on it?
Oh, no. The host is not playing that this year.
Trey calls Robert out. Trey addresses his issues with Robert. You know, we got the purse in the air. That's my favorite part. Robert calls out Trey for the show him. He said he likes the real Trey, but not the show Trey. It seems as though Trey and Robert squashed their issue. Robert addresses the Kesey and Dior situation once again. Kesey clarified what he actually meant when Lundie carried what he said to somebody else. And then we end it with Lundie versus Sean. Who wants to start?
Where do we begin?
Well, we can start it here. And this is another question for you, Markel. Do you feel that Rob comes into scenes with bad energy or with the intent on, you know, intimidating people?
No, I think that I think he comes into the scene and wanting clarity, and he wants you to be the same person you are on camera versus off camera. And he's not seeing that. And where Robert's frustration is coming from is that you tell him one thing, and then the next scene or the next moment or the next DM or whatever, it's a whole different story. So he's all over the place. So he just wants people to just tell the truth and just stand on it. And because no one's actually doing that, it's causing him to be a little bit more irate.
Okay, so with him saying that and him being the executive producer, Scotty, so what do you think about that?
You asking me?
Yeah, do you still think that he's a bully then?
Absolutely.
Why?
Because every time it's on camera, every time he talks to people, he sons them. He doesn't talk to them. He doesn't really explain what his issue is. He tries to explain it, but it's like when he explains it, it's like he's sunning them, and I don't like that energy, because if it was me in that conversation, I'll get up and leave. That's why I'm not on no reality show, because I'll get up and leave in a minute if I don't.
Well,
like
see, the problem is that when Robert comes onto the scene, you know, he has a little drink or he's probably high or something, so when he's trying to explain
You say he's high. Like, what type of high?
Weed.
Oh, okay. I didn't know what you meant.
Not a part 30.
Like, and because I think those two situations are happening, when he comes on camera, everybody knows what's happening. So there is no introduction to what's happening. He's like, let's just get into it. And you guys are not seeing the beginning part of that conversation. So it seems like he's just shutting them down, but it's like, you already know what I'm talking about, so why do I need to explain?
So because he's high and drunk, he gets aggressive with everybody.
No, that's not what I said. I said because he comes high and have a little something to drink, is that he doesn't explain things correctly for you guys to understand. That has nothing to do with the confession.
Are you talking about in scene or in confessional?
In scene.
Robert. In confessional?
Well, confessionals is different. Confessionals, you need to be a little more looser so you can say what you need to say.
Do you feel like he's clearing himself up even in his confessionals?
Yes and no. So I have told him that I said, you need to be a little more detailed and clarify. I said, because people like, okay, I know the truth and I know what's going on, but I'm like, the audience is not going to understand because you're not fully saying what's going
he's
on.
He's not. Yeah. It just like he just look crazy. I ain't gonna hold you. He look crazy. And I and that whole comment when you saying it like, because I know how it is off camera, on camera, and if somebody not you can do frustrate you. But on your green screen, that's your time to explain it to people. And he's doing a poor job of doing that. Right now, he's just a bully that wants to fight, and everybody's over it.
Yeah, because every time he in the scene, like even when they were sitting at the table and Sean was trying to speak, he it's like he's trying to sun him, like he interrupting him when he's trying to talk or cutting him off, or it's giving bully energy. I don't like that.
Sean is a bully. You just said that. But you didn't care about it because you don't.
I didn't say anything about Sean being a bully. What I said was, he's giving he's giving DeAndre what DeAndre has given everybody else. We're talking about Robert. And I said, and I'm going to stand on that, that I think that Robert comes across as a bully sometimes. I like Robert, but I don't like his bully energy. I don't get bully energy from Sean. I don't.
You don't?
He don't talk to people like he's sonning them.
Do you think because Robert's more aggressive with
him? He's very aggressive. He's aggressive. He talks to people like he's sonning them. He always threatening violence. That's bully shit to me.
By the way, I agree. I'm just asking questions.
You just trying to pick a fight with me. So you want to you've been trying to pick a fight with me for the last couple of days. I don't know what it is. I guess you enjoy arguing with me. I don't know what it is, honey. But you need to figure it out.
I am like, I am sitting here asking questions that the people want to know. because we have the producer like right underneath us, you know, basically giving point A and point B. And I was saying, like, with him giving this analyzation, how do you like still retain the information and feel the way that you feel? Like I feel like this is a good amount of questions, me personally. But
it is.
But like, do you feel that Sean?
Is this for me?
Yes.
Okay.
I've noticed a couple things. I've noticed two people that Rob has not tried or attempted to come at. And I noticed that it was Kesey.
Well, because he said this in the beginning, his issue is not with Kesey. Kesey is not Robert's brother.
I mean, but the thing is, the whole situation is involving Kesey. You can't.
But the issue is not with Kesey.
But it's involving me.
Well, that's almost like this. That's almost like me and you are together. You cheat on me with some other girl. Yes, she's involved, but you are my issue.
Period.
Yeah, but they're not in a relationship.
Well, we have the reunion to come up. No.
Yeah, the way things are going now, we don't know who in a relationship there.
And I'm saying, like, he's his brother, but he's been dragging him for most half of the season. For what I've been seeing. He's been dragging him on almost every episode, except, you know, after like that living room get together that they had. I don't know who house that was at. I think it might have been Trey's apartment or something.
When Oliver came in,
huh?
The one where Oliver came in and did like the little clearing the air with people.
Maybe I can't tell, but I'm saying before that specific event. Like Rob was dragging Dior, and it seemed to be a little bit more personal, and it seemed to be as if he was using this situation with Kesey to like pick a fight. But the thing is, if you're pressing Dior about sleeping with Kesey, but Kesey is saying, "I'm not sleeping with this man," how are you gonna tell him mind his business? That don't make sense.
In regards to Robert, now Robert was saying that Trey is messy. And my thing, Robert and Trey said it too, you are just as messy, because if we rewind back to that same color party, you said you brought your best friend there who used to date Kesey in order to confront Dior with the bullshit. And I was like, now that was messy, man. So that was very messy. So if you're gonna look at Trey, like Trey said, look, include yourself.
So then that goes back into, it's okay for him to do messy stuff and start drama between people, but when everybody else does it, he want to fight them. So is that like,
it was Robert saying that he didn't care about it? I was like, yes, you do.
Exactly, because you keep on talking about it. Like, well, I want to know, why does Dior have to stand on it? Who are you sleeping with? Robert, be coming here drunk and a little bit, coming here high and a little bit drunk, you know, per, you know what you said, and he don't want to talk about his life. He ain't sitting here talking about who he's sleeping with, talking about his chasing reality of Dallas.
So do you think that Robert has a right to feel how he feels about Dior and Kesey?
No.
Why not?
That don't make sense. Because regardless on my brother sleeping with my friend, man, that has nothing to do with me. Like, I'm not going to press you about that. Yeah, that may not be a cool thing to do, and it may not be that, like, but I'm not going to press you about who you sleeping with, because at the end
The little red camera, light is on that camera, bitch. My brother is going to see this, and I need to let him know that I pressed the issue.
Okay, but we're
TV. Everything is recorded. So bitch, you're not going to get me sitting in the corner eating my crab snack while my best friend sleeping with you my brother. And my best friend is sleeping with your fucking man, and I'm just sitting here in my little crabby patties in the corner. No, ma'am. Hey, excuse me. Why are y'all fucking? I need to know.
You literally was agreeing with me when we talked about this.
Until that.
You was literally agreeing with me.
Y'all realize you still gotta know how this TV shit works, bitch. And bitches will pull up the scene like, oh, you over here these crabby patties in the corner, and you knew these bitches was fucking, then how you gonna explain that?
With your face? You could be like, I had no idea. Like that.
No,
like,
fuck that.
No, you can't do that.
No, you can't do that.
Not on this show. You can't do that.
I mean, I don't know.
The principle of what Robert is saying, I definitely understand the principle, so it makes sense to me.
Okay, now, but does that involve you calling him a fake ass bitch too?
The more we talk about this, the more I'm side with Robert. Slap the shit out of all them bitches, okay? At this point, I'm with Robert now. Slap all them
bitches. Yeah, I ain't had to open up my goddamn mouth. I said I was going to windmill for Robert. I ain't got to.
I'm with Robert at this point. Slap them bitches.
The reason why he calls him a fake-ass bitch is because his thing is this. If Tony... Okay, so I'm sorry. Robert and Tony Robert and Dior are brothers. All three of them grew up together. They're all in the same house, same brotherhood. They done did things together. Like, they are brothers. So when Tony was dating Kesey, Dior knew about it. He was all up in the mix in some type of capacity, whatever. They break up. So now you, quote unquote, Dior and Kesey has something going on. They said on the first episode, hey, there could be something going on. There's some type of kiss that trade. Like, things are coming out saying that things are happening. But when Robert comes and say, hey, this is an issue, now your story is changing. But there's
somebody was saying that Kesey and Dior was messing around.
Yeah, we've been talking about it all season.
However, on the second episode, in the very beginning, Trey went to them and said, okay, so what's going on between you guys? And then Kesey was like, I mean, there's a little something. And then Dior said, well, there's other competition in here. So it was kind of validated for Roberts to see that. So his thing is, if I'm asking you what's going on and now your story is changing because now you see Tony and I have an issue, who is being fake? Why is the story changing? So stand 10 toes down in your response.
So
now I'm not saying this is true or anything, you guys. I'm just going off what the show happened.
But because you're on here and you're reviewing the show with us, do you think that Kesey and Dior have gotten inappropriate with one another?
Yeah.
No, I want him to answer.
Hey, 69 in jail.
I have not physically seen it, but do I believe so?
Possibly. Yeah.
But no, I think so too.
Did they sleep in the same room when they were out there?
I have to challenge Robert's thing again, because Tony, from what we understood, I think he came on the after show and said that he is currently in a relationship and that him and Kesey's thing was 4 years ago. So it's like if he's in a whole different relationship and they've already
that moved. Doesn't matter, Jamar. Jamar,
it does.
No, it doesn't. Jamar, you and Scotty, let's say y'all been friends for 10 years. If Scotty,
we have,
they have.
If Scotty was dating somebody 4 years ago, he broke up with him, and now you're dating him. That is wrong. It doesn't matter. But see
that, then hold on. But hold on. We also don't know the nature, because if that was just somebody that she was just fucking from Grindr, and then he happened to be.
They've been messing around for 4 years. They both, Kesey said they were in a relationship. So let's not deflect. Whoa, right?
Wait. Were they in a relationship for 4 years, or were they just fucking 4 years ago?
Okay, well, I don't know the semantics of the detail of the timeline. All I know is they have been broken up for 4 years, but they have both admitted that they were in a relationship, regardless if it was a day or 8 months. They both said they was in a relationship.
Wow. So do you weigh your 10-year relationship the same way you weigh your 2-week relationship?
Let me tell you something. If any of my family members or brothers or sisters date somebody who I used to date, it is wrong. I don't care if it's 30 years ago. No, what are you doing? It's 90 million other people that you can be sleeping with, but you want to choose this person?
Yeah, I'm on your side with that one. I'm going to beat your ass. If I ever found somebody
and tell me what you saw, ever shoot somebody
that I was once with, I love you, friend, but we're going to have to windmill. We're going to have to windmill, then we can get drinks late.
Tell me how you was attracted to him, because bitch, she was with me first. How the fuck did you meet her? So you've been left to this bitch the whole time.
Yeah.
So now you can ask.
But the thing is, like, my thing is, like, if both of the people are saying no, then there's nothing else that you can really do.
But then you have to look at this. Both people are saying no episodes later, but episodes prior, they're saying something totally different.
I blame TSI for not telling me.
So how are you reviewing that situation and you didn't even watch the beginning episodes?
Ooh.
Huh? You said what?
How are you reviewing their situation and you didn't watch the previous episodes in the very beginning to know how it started?
Because I was asked to.
Jeremy has to answer the question.
That's my answer. I was asked to. I was asked to come on here.
I know, but you didn't think to, like, okay, well, I'm 2 episodes behind. Let me not catch up on the first 2 episodes.
You seen it from the beginning. No, we caught this on episode 3.
Oh.
What you're missing is
on episode 1 and 2.
Well, you know.
You need the whole story.
Okay, so this child, I hope I can save this long shit. Okay, so we at the what about this Lundy and Sean thing?
I think Lundy was looking for a moment. He ain't been really what y'all talking about lately.
Lundy was completely in the right about the situation.
Was he though?
Good job. Yes.
Boo.
And I can explain it from point A to point B.
Go ahead.
Please, start from A.
All right. Let's explain it, please.
First and foremost, it wasn't like they asked him, was he coming? He didn't call them and say, I'm not coming because such and such and such and such. They asked him, was he coming or not? He was like, I'm not really comfortable being in the same room. You know, it feels like they're a couple. And according to what Markel is saying, it's not out of the question now that he may feel like they are a couple. And he don't want to be in the same room. Like, it makes him feel uncomfortable. Nobody told Trey and Ted Lee to be eavesdropping, to go spread that to everybody else, because he wasn't saying it to be messy. He was just giving the reason as why he didn't want to go. Then on top of that, when whatchamacallit, what is the name? Jetty Jeff? Was going around with the, like, I don't know if it was a Trey spreading the rumor that Ted Lee and Lon D was doing stuff together, and he said, of course he could probably feel that way, probably care, because he slid up into my DMs. That makes sense to me. That was 100% in the right too. And then when he got to the table, all he did was cement what he felt, and he stood 10 toes down on it. And the thing is, how am I not supposed to believe that Dior and Kesey are doing stuff if you're a child? The child that you're claiming is alluding that y'all are doing stuff.
Wait a minute, I think we're talking about two different things.
Yeah, no, I'm like, what the hell?
Because I'm saying all of the, like, because they were saying he was trying to search for a moment. I was like, it wasn't a moment. Like,
no,
Jeff,
Not that moment. They're talking about the moment between him and Keyshawn.
Yeah, we talk about Sean and no,
because I'm saying that that led into the conversation because he was saying at the end of the day, y'all was the ones who were talking about them in a relationship at the table. And y'all sitting here talking about you be staying out of stuff. You did not stay out of it. You were alluding and like being messy and making me believe that they was doing stuff with Trey. And then he was like, I did not do. Yes, you did do that. You did do that. That's another reason I don't like Sean. Sean, he's good on the show, but Sean is not real.
I'll agree to disagree. He was looking for a moment.
It was Jeff who started the whole thing.
So, he definitely started it, but.
But what? Let's talk about the Londi and Kesey thing where they said that they had talked about it. Like, if you suspected that, and if I said and I tell you, like, look, ain't nothing going on. It's just this. People are acting this way because of whatever reason. And then you turn back and talk to people and say, like, oh, they're still a couple. It's just like, so then what was the point of that entire conversation? It's like,
even in the conversation, it felt like Londi still didn't believe them. He was like, you know, okay.
Well,
you will not believe it. You better say that. Don't sit there and, congregate and, you know, fellowship with me and then sit there and not believe shit that I got.
Was they fellowshipping?
Well, apparently there was.
Did he call Londi to help him with a photo shoot, and then his manager came in and decided to bogart and say, "You ain't gonna do this. You ain't gonna be tooting your ass up in the air like that. You ain't gonna be opening your legs like that. Not at this photo shoot." You know, like did that
girl
not happen?
What?
I swear that's how it happened. And Londi was like, "Well, this ain't the energy of somebody who just managing." Cause he was acting like Kesey about to be on a Hot 100 tomorrow.
I'm dead.
And where's the photo shoot?
It's been posted.
Child, I need to go see. But like, Londi was in the right. They tried to press Londi, and they thought Londi was going to back down when they pressed him, and he stood 10 toes down in what he said, and I respect that.
I just feel like it's a lot of unnecessary ass drama here. Is it just these fact people just don't like each other, or because some of the arguments I feel like be so goddamn pointless? Like, are y'all just don't like each other, or bitches looking for a moment? What's happening?
Do you think people on the cast? Do you think people on the cast are jealous of Kesey and Dior?
Because hell yeah, because they want to be.
Because they may or not want to be with one of them, Markel.
I don't believe that at all.
Okay,
I believe that.
So you don't think nobody on the cast want Kesey or Dior?
Say it again.
You don't think nobody on that cast really wants Kesey or Dior?
Uh-uh. I mean, I think that if they were to approach them, no. Because no.
My thing is, why is it such a problem? If I'm fucking, I mean, yeah.
That's what I said. Why is it an issue?
I'm going to ask y'all a question, even though you guys haven't seen the review.
I would.
Yeah, you can ask it.
What is something that you guys want to be cleared up and in for all? Like, what is something you just like, listen, I need to know the truth about what happened.
I really want to know why Robert Ray was dragging the shit out of Dior all of those episodes, but not keeping that same energy in front of him. Unless that was,
and I just want to know if Kesey and Dior fucking so we can lay it to rest once and for all.
They never gonna tell you the truth. And in a day, and like you're putting that poon cat on him, he ain't about to talk.
It's like
he could be putting the poon cat on. You don't know.
I mean, but either way, like Dior is giving mature fish. He like he has Kesey in alignment. Kesey ain't about to. He was up to like, when is it? We ain't doing nothing. Like he was looking. He be looking at Dior to like for answers to questions. Like Dior got him whipped. Whatever he whipping him.
Now he got him whipped.
If they doing stuff, maybe it's because that's his manager.
Answer that the audience would accept unless it's their fucking. Like there's no other scenario that the audience is gonna believe. They're just gonna say that y'all fucking.
And I think they make a cute couple.
Would they though?
They make a cute couple.
Yeah, to me they would.
I don't know. Yeah. I feel like Kesey and Londi would make a cute couple.
Absolutely.
You think so?
Yeah.
I'm not seeing that at all.
I don't see. To me, because like I guess it's like it looks like a real big age difference between the two.
I don't think if you knew.
How old is Kesey?
To me, Kesey, like he's about 25, 26.
Oh no.
Yeah.
And then he might be even younger than that.
No, nah, like, he is not that young now.
I don't know. You know, but
how old is Lundin? Like 38?
No.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry.
How old is Dior?
Dior just turned 39 in December. He'll be 40 in December.
How old is Kesey?
Kesey's 27 or 8. He's not 30. I know. He's not 30. He's 27. The late 20s.
I didn't know Dior was about to be 40.
That's why I said he's older. He gives daddy energy. That's why he be keeping Kesey in check. Like you don't say nothing unless I tell you to.
Uh-uh.
We ain't together.
Well, you know what? On that note, because this shit long as hell anyway. On that note. Well, this was fun. Thank you, Markel, for coming up. And Jeremy, I told you, Markel is with the Miss Child. He not gonna come up here and chastise you for what your opinion.
I didn't know you that well. And it's so funny because Scotty being messy because he did not have to bring that up. But I was saying, because I didn't know who you were. I thought like you were one of their friends. And I was like, we've been dragging, me and Carl have been dragging the hell out of a lot of people up on here.
So, I know, I've been watching.
I didn't know if you had came on here to defend anybody's honor and I was going to have to back you up a while for me. So I didn't know that was
back you above me, okay?
So like, but he assured me that wasn't the case, and you came in with great energy, and I'm pleased.
Oh well, good. Well, I tried to tell him. Speaking about the show all this time, you know, even though some people said it was boring and not enough drama, and
that was me.
I know him. I'm looking at you.
It was me.
I do think that, you know, since it was like a reboot and a lot of people didn't come back this season, so we had to just give new people chances and just see what happens and then go from there. But I think so far, huh?
No, go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Maybe because I'm being biased because I did it, but, you know, I enjoyed this season. I was thoroughly entertained and laughed.
Well, when should we expect the reunion to come out since next week is the finale?
Next Thursday. I don't, there shouldn't be a delay.
Memorial Day weekend.
Are you guys going to be doing like a chasing Atlanta? I know y'all have a chasing Atlanta already, but I heard through the grapevine, i.e. Scotty, that the show is going to be like going on hiatus or something.
I didn't say that.
I thought it was going to be going on hiatus because when I had said, like, is George going to chasing Atlanta then?
I said no.
Because the show is going on hiatus.
No, it's not. They're filming, Jeremy. That's what I said.
I could have swore you said it was going on hiatus.
I didn't say that, honey.
Where did that come from then?
I don't know where that came from, child.
Child, I heard it through the grapevine. But anyway,
I absolutely did not say that.
But is there any way Carl could be a part, like, or audition?
I think Carl mentioned it maybe last week or the week before. He's been on almost every season of Chasing Atlanta in the background.
Look,
but what if we put him in the forefront?
Look, they took something. I couldn't get a confessional. Explain myself. They were dragging my name all through the mud. Because I did not say that.
I mean, I don't control the cast over Atlanta, so he would have to speak to Andario or when they do actually post the casting and go from there. But
yeah, they didn't post one this season.
Connie be on like, somebody's show. No, he's gone.
That was the perfect time. Y'all should have used them.
Oh, well.
Wait, what happened?
They was basically saying he should have just, while Andario was in here, we should have asked him about Carl being on the show, basically. Mm-hmm. So many words.
I mean, he was performing at the Boss Babe Awards. You did the cipher, right? The hip, aha.
I did.
He definitely did.
Like, did you ask them?
Mm-mm, but I was drunk as fuck. He was.
Definitely drunk.
But Carl, are you friends with anybody who is on the current cast?
I am. I'm friends with most of them, actually.
Why don't you just show up to some scenes?
Oh yeah, that'd be cute. I didn't think to do that.
And like just make
your way through, have a product, have an event, let them come to yours, you know.
I always got a product. My album come out in July. What's up?
Throw a drink in somebody's face too. I'm just kidding.
Well, chat. Thank you, Markel, for coming up. And we are done for tonight. Jeremy mentioned last night on when me and Tramiel was on live with Jeremy. He said something about instead of doing pre-records for the finale, he made a suggestion that we go live. Would y'all be down for us just going live?
I would have thought we would have did. I would enjoy this a lot more live because the comments have me dying.
Okay,
we'll definitely live. I'll get out the bed for live and put a shirt on.
Is there a reason that you wanted to do it pre-recorded?
Because we was only doing it because it was just me, Jamar, and T at first. So we were just doing joint reviews at first. But then we didn't know that Tramiel was going to be added, and we didn't know y'all two was going to be added, so it became a thing. So, you know, that's the only reason. I didn't know it was going to be a big thing.
Somebody was messaging me, and it came on my live. They were telling me that we should do Bad Boys, but I don't know when that starts.
It already started. What Bad Boys? Which one? The one that's on Zeus or the one that's on
Zeus?
Zeus or the original?
Jeremy just confused. He said, "Which?"
Natalie stole that right from under.
The one that's on Zeus already started.
Okay.
And T already checked out of that one.
Both of them already started.
I'm okay on that one. I'm gonna have to gracefully bow out the cast. I'm not watching that episode.
Look, I'm gonna end it so we can continue this conversation. Okay, thank y'all for watching. Bye. Because if I don't end this shit, now this shit gonna be 2 hours.